Let's start the homework questions for derivatives of logarithmic functions. And over here on the right hand side, we do have the derivative of ln of f of x, which is 1 over f of x times the derivative of f of x. All right, so if we apply that for the very first question here, we would start off by writing y prime equals 2. And then the definition states that we always start off with 1 over everything inside the ln function. So this is your f of x now. So this would be 1 over x squared plus 3x plus 1. And then we just multiply by the derivative of the inside, and the derivative of the inside is 2x plus 3. And although that's a correct answer, we can simplify the answer by writing this as 2x plus 3. And then we can divide that by just x squared plus 3x plus 1. All right, so that's the answer for the very first question. Let's move on to the next question here. I have y equals to ln of x squared minus 1. All right, so if we start off with the derivative, we would start off by writing y prime equals. Now, the derivative of this outside ln, that first ln, is going to be 1 over, and then everything on the inside, which is this green stuff right here, which is ln of bracket x squared minus 1. And then we take the derivative, of the bottom function here. And what's the derivative of that? Well, the derivative of ln of anything is 1 over the anything, which is x squared minus 1. And then finally, we take the derivative of, let me just clean that up here. This is x squared minus 1. And then we take the derivative of this inside, and that derivative will be just 2x. Okay, so there you go. That's the derivative for that one. And if you want to just clean this up, I want to write this as y prime equals 2. And then we'll have a 2x on the denominator, a 2x on the numerator. And then on the denominator, we'll have ln of bracket x squared minus 1 times bracket x squared minus 1. And that's your final answer for that particular question there. Okay, let's keep on moving along here. This one's not too bad because we have a power of 3 on the outside. So using the power rule, this would be y prime equals to 3 bracket ln x. And then the 3 gets decreased by 1, so I have a power of 2 here. And then based on the chain rule, I take the derivative of the inside, and the derivative of ln x is just 1 over x. Okay, so there is the derivative for that. And if we were to kind of clean this up, I would write this as y prime equals to 3 bracket ln x to the power 2 all divided by x. And basically this x is that x right there. Okay, let's keep on going here. All right, the next question here, there's a few ways where you could do this particular problem. The fastest way is to recognize that ln e is equal to 1. So if we were just to simplify this using ln properties, all of this, that would just cancel off. So then this x would survive as just 4x, and the derivative of 4x is simply going to be 4. So that's one way where you could do the particular problem. The other way where you could find the derivative of this problem is we can start off by writing y prime equals 2. Now there's a constant here of 4, so I leave the constant out in front, and then ask yourself, well, what's the derivative of this using the rule? Well, the f of x is e to the x, so it would be 1 over e to the x, and then times by the derivative of the bottom, and what's the derivative of e to the x? Well, the derivative of e to the x is e to the x. Okay, and then you'll notice that basically this and this will cancel off, giving you just this 4, which is the final answer as well. So there's a few ways where you can get the final answer of 4 for that particular problem there. Okay, let's keep on going on here. Okay, what I see now here is I have e to the power of x times ln x. I kind of see x being multiplied with ln x there, so I see a product rule on the power there. And if we go ahead and start with the derivative, it would start off as y prime equals. And the derivative of e to the f of x, derivative of e to the f of x is e to the f of x times f prime of x, right? So that's the derivative of e to the anything, right? And if we go ahead and apply that to this particular problem now, I would start off by writing y prime equals 2. Now we start off with the original function, which is e to the power of x times ln x. And then I'm going to multiply that by the derivative of the power. So once again, we're going to use the product rule now. So the derivative of x is going to be 1, and then we times that by ln x, and then we add that to the first term, which is x, and then we multiply by the derivative of ln x, which is 1 over x. And then I close that bracket there. Okay, so what I see here is I have an x times 1 over x, so that and that cancel, and that just gives me a 1. So if I want to erase this and just write this as a plus 1, I can. And I guess that would be it for your final answer here. I mean, you can't really simplify this any further. I mean, e to the power of x times ln x, bracket ln x plus 1. Not much you can do in terms of simplifying that particular problem there. Okay, let's keep on moving along here. Now I have a ln x function where we're going to use the quotient rule. So let's start off with y prime equals. And the quotient rule states that I need to have the derivative of the numerator. So that's going to be 1 over x. And then I'm going to multiply that with the denominator, which is x squared. And then the quotient rule states that I need to subtract. And then I can subtract the top part, which is ln x. And then I times by the derivative of the bottom, which is just 2x. And then I can divide the entire thing. The entire thing as being squared on the denominator there. Okay, and then we'll just take another line to simplify this if we can. So y prime equals 2. Okay, so I have x squared and a single x. So that x goes away and that x goes away. So I just have a single x when I multiply those first two terms. Then I have a minus sign. And then I guess I'll bring the 2x in front. So 2x times ln x. And on the bottom there, I just have x to the power of 4. Okay, so I'm just kind of examining this. And I mean, the only other thing I can do right now is I can factor out an x here and I factor out an x there. So if I factor out that x, I guess I'll have 1 there minus 2 times ln x. And then on the denominator there, I have x to the power of 4. And what I see right now is there's an x here and x to the power of 4, so that can cancel out with that. And if I fully simplify this, I just have a 3 here now. And that should conclude the final answer for that problem there. Okay, so not too bad. Let's check out an implicit derivative question now. Let's take a look at the implicit derivative problem now. And I have ln of x times y. So one thing I noticed right away is there's a product inside the ln function. So chances are we will have to use the product rule here. All right, so if we start taking the derivative of the left-hand side, this will be 1 over the inside, which is x times y. And then we multiply that by the derivative of the inside. So using the product rule now, the derivative of x is 1. And then we multiply that by the second term, which is y, plus the first term, which is x. And then we multiply by the derivative of the second term, which is just y prime. And then I can close the brackets. And then on the right-hand side, the derivative of x is going to be 1. And then I will subtract that from the derivative of the second term there. So the derivative of y is going to be y prime. Okay, so this is looking pretty good. And one thing that you could do is instead of distributing this into the brackets, I wouldn't do that. Recognize that there's an xy on the denominator, and you can move that to the right-hand side by simply multiplying everything on the right-hand side by x times y. If I do that correctly, I would get bracket. So this would be just 1 times y, and then plus. Well, I'll keep the colors all the same here. So 1 times y plus x times y prime, close that bracket, equals 2. All right, so here comes the multiplication part. The xy remains like that, and we're multiplying that onto everything on the right-hand side. So this will be 1 minus y prime. So that's a very nice way to just get rid of that x times y. You just multiply both sides by x times y, and then you can get rid of the denominator there. Okay, so this is looking pretty good. And if I simplify the left-hand side, well, this expression right here is going to be 1 times y, which is y, plus, and then this term here is just itself, which is x times y prime. And then we don't need the brackets here. And if we distribute this into the brackets here, we get xy, and then minus xy times y prime. Okay, so now we need to get all the y primes on one side here. So this negative x times y prime, that term here in yellow, I'm gonna move that to the left-hand side, and this single y, I'm gonna move that to the right-hand side. So if I do that correctly there, this will be x times y prime, and then I can subtract or add this to xy times y prime, and then this is equal to xy minus that y. Okay, so now I can factor out the y primes. If I factor out the y primes correctly, I get y prime, and then bracket, and I get x plus xy, and close that bracket there, and then this is going to equal to xy minus the y. Okay, almost done here. I can now divide everything by the expression in the brackets there. So the xy minus y remains, and this will be divided by just x plus xy. Okay, so that's looking pretty good. I mean, if you want to continue simplifying this, I guess you can factor out the y's on the numerator there. So if you factor out the y's on the numerator, I get x minus 1, and if I factor out the x's on the denominator there, I guess the x would come out, and then we would get just 1 plus y. So yeah, that's about it. I don't think I can really simplify that any further, and I'll leave the y prime on the left-hand side there. All right, so that's it for that particular question there. Let's move on to the next one here. Okay, so now I have y equals to ln I have ln of a bunch of other ln functions here. So let's go slowly here. Let's start with this first outside ln function, okay? So if I want to take the derivative, I start off by writing y prime. Okay, so then let me start out with a 1 all over. And then basically this entire green function here, all the green stuff will be underneath the denominator there. So if I write that correctly, this will be ln a bracket tan a bracket e to the power of x squared. Close that bracket, close that bracket, close that bracket. Okay. So now I'm done with that ln. And then I multiply that by, let me erase all this now, and now we're multiplying by the derivative of the denominator. So if I say focus here, the derivative of the ln starting with that function will be 1 all over. And then on that denominator, I'm gonna have all of this now, right? So that's gonna be ln a bracket tan a bracket e to the power of x squared, close a bracket. And then I multiply by the derivative of this denominator now, and the derivative of that will start with this ln function, so that'll be 1 all over tan a bracket e to the x squared, close the bracket. And then I multiply by the derivative of this, and the derivative of tan e to the x squared is going to be secant squared bracket e to the x squared. And then finally, the chain rule states that I need to multiply by the derivative of that, and that final derivative is e to the power of x squared times that, which will be the derivative of x squared, which is 2x. Okay. So that was pretty brutal there. There's quite a bit of functions to put all together there. So a very long problem indeed. I guess if you wanted to write this out and simplify this, it'd be probably best to start at the very tail end here. So if I just erase some of these arrows here, if I had to kind of simplify everything here, I would start off with the 2x. The 2x I would put on the numerator is 2x. And then I would work backwards. I would then put the e to the power of x squared next to it. So e to the power of x squared, close that bracket. And then you have this secant squared e to the power of x squared. So I would put the secant squared bracket e to the power of x squared. And then I would divide everything by, okay, well, let's start with the least ugliest function here. And that looks like this tan function right here. That is the tan function. So I'd put the tan function out in front. So tan bracket e to the x squared, close that bracket. And then after that, it looks like this function in the middle has only one ln function. So let's put that next to the tan function. So ln of bracket tan of bracket e to the x squared, close a bracket, close a bracket. And then finally, we can just multiply that by the last function there, which is ln of bracket tan bracket e to the x squared. Okay, so quite a bit of functions there, and then just stretch that out, I guess. Okay, so that was a little bit messy, so hopefully that's a good way to kind of help simplify the final answer there. So a lot of work for that particular question there. Okay, let's keep on moving on. I think we have a few more tangent line questions to go, and then we can finish up. So for this particular question, I need to find the equation of the tangent line at the point x equals to 1 here. Okay, so let's figure this out. If x equals to 1, we should go ahead and find the y value. So if you want to find the y value, I'd definitely evaluate f of 1. So f of 1 basically means anytime you see an x, you just replace all those x's with the 1. So this will be ln of bracket 1 and then minus 1 all over bracket squared with the 1 on the denominator there, right? Now, ln of 1 is going to be 0, right? So we have 0 minus 1 divided by 1. And if we do all the math there, it looks like the y value here is going to be negative 1 here. So negative 1 divided by 1 is going to be negative 1. Okay, so what that means is that the tangent line will intersect the graph at the coordinates of 1, comma, negative 1. Okay, so that's part one. We got to find the y value there. And if you went ahead and created a tangent line with the information you have, it'd be y plus 1 equals to m bracket x minus 1. Okay. So far, so good. And finally, with any other tangent line problem, our goal is to find the derivative value, which is labeled m here. Okay, so let's go ahead and apply the quotient rule here. So if I go ahead and find the quotient rule, it'll be y prime equals. Okay, let me erase all that. So I need the derivative of ln x minus 1. And the derivative of the numerator is going to be bracket 1 over x. And the derivative of negative 1 is going to be 0. So that's it for the numerator. And then I multiply that by the denominator, which is x squared. And then the quotient rule states that there's a minus sign. And then I need the numerator, which is bracket ln x minus 1. And then I multiply by the derivative of the denominator, which is just 2x. And then I divide by the denominator all squared. Okay, that looks pretty good. Now, remember, we're trying to find the derivative value at x equals to 1. And instead of simplifying all of this, I would go ahead and evaluate f prime of 1 if you can. So what that really means is that instead of simplifying this, we're going to change all these x's with a 1, right? So if we do that, so the first bracket is going to be 1. The second bracket is going to be 1 squared, which is 1, minus, and then ln of 1 here. Ln of 1 there is going to be, I think we calculated that, sorry, but no, we didn't. We did, but we erased it. But ln of 1 is going to be 0, so 0 minus 1. And then 2 times 1 is going to be 2, divided by, well, 1 squared is 1, and then 1 squared again is also going to be 1. So that's pretty good. Instead of actually simplifying it, we could just plug in the x values and find the derivative value numerically. So this is 1 minus, if I distribute that, I get a negative 2, and there's a 1 on the bottom there. So this will be 1 plus 2, which is going to be 3. All right, so the slope value is going to be 3. And if I go back to my tangent line here, I guess we can just change this m now to a 3, right? So that right there is the equation of my tangent line. Okay, so not too bad. Let's go ahead and just take a look at the graph here, and then we'll finish off this particular problem here. If I take a look at this graph now, the blue function is my original function, which is y equals to ln x minus 1 all over x squared. And the equation of my tangent line, which is there in red, the equation of that tangent line is y plus 1 equals to 3 bracket x minus 1. And I guess the point of tangency is this point right here, which is 1 comma negative 1. And basically, this was the coordinates that we found right from the get-go, right? X is given to us, which is x equals to 1, and then we found the y value, which is negative 1. And once again, this is that intersection point, right? So that's generally the first thing that you find when you're dealing with these tangent line questions. You're just finding out when the tangent line intersects with the original function, and then you go ahead and find the rest of the graph there. Okay, so that's what the visual diagram looks like for that particular problem there. Okay, let's move on to the last question of this homework video guide. Okay, so find the equation of the tangent line to the curve of y equals to ln x here. Okay, from the external point 0, 1. Okay, so before I kind of start this problem, it might be good to draw a little visual here to kind of get started here. So ln x kind of looks like this. And you don't need to draw this in your notes here. This is just kind of give you like a visual here. And the point 0, 1, well, that's a y-intercept, right? So maybe the y-intercept is right here. And the question's saying that you have like this tangent line that goes through there and intersects the graph somewhere around there, right? So what we're trying to find is the equation of that red line there. Now, it's important to note that the red line goes through the point 0, 1 and also intersects this point, which is x, y. And one of the reasons why I drew this question is because it's very important that students know that there's two points in this problem, right? One of the points is given to you, which is the y-intercept in this case, and then you have this other random point, which is x, y, which is, you know, we'll do our best to find that, right? And then once we know that, we can find the equation of the tangent line. So what I normally do now is I kind of set these two columns where I have a Math 10 column, and I also have a Calculus 12 column. And in Math 10, we just call the slope just a slope. And then in Calculus 12, we call that the derivative, right? Now in Math 10, in order to find the slope, we usually use this formula between two points, y minus y1 all over x2 minus x1. And over here on the derivative, we'll call that y prime. Okay, now the issue is that the two points that we're given, the two points that we have are 0, 1, and we have this other random point x, y. So when you're solving a problem like this, you have to be able to use these points and insert them correctly into your slope formula there, right? So the order doesn't matter as long as you have the x and y values matching up. So if I had to apply the formula here, I could do something like this. I could write y minus 1 on the numerator. And if I do that, then the denominator has to be x minus 0. Okay, and then that will equal to the derivative. So I have y prime, right? So what is y equal to? Well, y is equal to ln x. So the derivative of ln x is 1 over x. Okay? And then ask yourself, well, now we have this kind of this equation here that kind of looks like the problems that you saw in pre-calculus 11, but the problem is there's an x variable, and a y variable, right? Your goal now is we need to replace this y variable, right? And in this problem, y is equal to ln x. That's the key, right? So instead of writing y, I can write ln x, and then minus 1 all over, and then the denominator is just x. And then I have a 1 over x over here. Okay, so now we need to solve this particular equation here. And this one's not too bad because I see this x on the denominator, and I'm just going to move that to the right-hand side by multiplying with that 1. So if I do that, 1 times x is going to be x, and then the denominator is also going to be an x. And then on the left-hand side, I just have the ln x minus the 1. Okay, so I'm just multiplying the 1 with the ln x. Sorry, 1 with the x to get a single x there. Now, if you look at this very carefully, especially on the right-hand side, I mean, x over x is just 1. Okay, x over x is 1. And then I take this negative 1, I bring that over. So now I have ln x equals to 2 here. And then in order to get rid of the ln, I need to raise both sides to the power of e. If we do that, x would equal to e to the power of 2. All right, so that's very important. So x is e to the power of 2. Okay, so what does that really mean now? If I go back to the original problem or this original graph here, what we just found was that this x value right here is just e to the power of 2. So if I just have to update my graph now, I have e to the power 2, and now we're going to find the y value, right? Well, the y value, I mean, you just plug in e to the power 2 there, right? So if I have ln of bracket e to the power 2, this just equals to a single 2, right? So this ln and that e, that cancels off, and then this 2 just survives, right? So the y value ends up being 2. So if I just change my graph now, I have a 2 here, right? So that's the intersection point. Okay. Anyhow, let's see if we can write the equation of that line now. So let me just erase all this. What's really important is that we can write the final answer now. Remember, we have to write the equation of that tangent line, and the tangent line has this form, which is y minus y1 equals to m bracket x minus x1. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and I will probably just use the easiest point, and I think this point right here is very easy, right? So that's going to be y minus 1 equals to m bracket x minus 0. Okay, and then we need to find the derivative, right? Okay, so we got to find the slope of that linear line. So we have the two points, so we can use y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. We could do that. But we know the function is ln x, right? So the derivative of ln x, the derivative of ln x is just 1 over x, right? And we know the x value that we have here is just e to the power of 2, right? So remember, at this particular point, we know the x value is e to the power 2. So if I evaluate f prime of e to the power 2, I get 1 over e to the power 2. So that means that this slope right here, my final answer will be y minus 1 equals to 1 over e to the power 2 bracket x minus 0. And that right there should be my final answer there. And once again, I know the derivative of ln x is 1 over x, right? And what I'm doing now is I'm just changing that x with one, with e to the power 2, because that was the x value that we found. Okay, pretty much done now. Let me just give you a visual of the complete graph here. Here it is. Here's the complete graph. And the red graph, as I mentioned at the start of the problem, was y equals to ln x. And the purple graph, if I have a purple marker here, the equation of the purple graph is going to be y minus 1 equals to 1 over e squared times x minus 0. So the purple line is the equation of that linear line, and this intersection point right here, if I wrote this in, if I wrote that in exact form, it'd be e to the power 2 comma 2. All right, so that's what the final graph would look like if you had to graph everything, and this is the external point that was given to us at the start of the problem, which is 0 comma 1. Okay, so that concludes this homework video guide on derivatives of logarithmic functions.